Hello friends, my name is Ria and today in this video I'm going to explain a program which is based on inter-process communication using pipes. So pipes are of two types, namely named pipes and unnamed pipes. So as the name suggests, named pipe has got a specified name whereas unnamed pipe does not have a name. Okay, so named pipe can be created by using MK node system call or MK FIFO system call. Okay, whereas unnamed pipe can be created with the help of pipe system call. Now pipe system call has got two. Now pipe system call syntax is pipe and in the bracket we have FTPTR. Now in pipe system call there can be two pointers. One is for the reader and another one is for the writer. Okay, so for example we have FT of 0 and FT of 1. Now FT of 0 represents the reader and FT of 1 represents the writer. Okay, so let's do the first question. So what does the first question say? It says develop a C program using system calls to implement the named pipes. So process 1, which is called the writer process, it creates the pipe and writes a string into the pipe. Process 2, which is the reader process, it opens and reads the string from the pipe and displays the number of vowels in that string. Okay, now let us see both the programs one by one, writer and then the reader. Okay, so we have it as, yeah, so this is my writer program. So what I'm doing is, here the buffer size is 100. Now I've already created the pipe. Okay, so if you type ls and go and see, you can easily find that the my pipe called my pipe is already existing. Okay, so since my pipe is already existing, there is no need of, I've already executed this program several times, so that is why there is need for creating a pipe only in the initial stage, only in the beginning. Now I've already created the pipe, there's no need of creating the pipe again and again. Or else if you want to create a pipe, you have to create it with a different name. Now since it is already existing, we do not need to create the pipe again. So what we have to do is, from next time onwards, we just need to open the pipe. Okay, so we already opened the pipe and then we need to get the input from the user. So here in this part we are getting the input from the user and we are just calculating the length and then finally we are writing it into the buffer. Now let's see the reader program. Okay, fine, we'll open it in different terminal so that there's no confusion. So we have, yeah, this is my reader process. So here what is happening, we are opening the pipe and then finally and we are reading the content of the buffer and it is displaying the received content, and after we are getting the received content, we need to calculate the value of the buffer, sorry, length of the buffer, and then we have to check whether whatever value is there in the buffer, it is a vowel or not, and count the number of vowels and finally display it. Now let us see how this program, both of these program runs. Do everything simultaneously so that it becomes easy. First when I compile this, only then. Okay, so in order to compile, we need to type writer dot out there. Yeah, so I'm entering find the string Karunya. Yeah, we can see that the reader has received the words and it is also displaying the number of vowels. So this is my first program. My next program is based on unnamed pipes. So in unnamed pipes, you have to create a developer C program using system calls to implement the unnamed pipes. So parent process would create the pipe and write the integer number into the pipe, and the child process would read the integer number from the pipe and tell whether the number is entered, number entered is odd or even. So we'll go and see the second revision. Second program. So what I've done is we have created the child process and we are checking if id equal to 0. If it is so, then the number that we have received, we are checking whether that number is divisible by 2 or not, and if it is divisible by 2, we are displaying that the value is print, otherwise it is odd. Sorry, the value is even, otherwise it is odd. Okay, now in the else part refers to the parent process. In the else part, we are getting the input from the user and we are writing it into the buffer, and that value is transferred to the child process, and there that value is checked whether it is even or odd. Okay, and let us see how this program runs. Okay, we'll just write it. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching.